Yes,
This conference will now be recorded.
Hi guys, I'm Raju, the SAP solve maintainer for you. I hope you guys can hear me right, and as well as you guys can able to see my screen, the paint one. Okay. So let's start. So we'll go with the SAP solution manager. So we simply call as Solman. Okay. So myself, I'm Raju. So I offer in Hyderabad for Capgemini. So let's see what is exactly the solution manager, the work of solution manager, and as well as we got a new version 7.2, the new version of this, the solution manager and different types of activities, the new dashboard, all the stuff. Let me know before starting. Let me know you guys have any experience on any solution manager, SAP basis, or any DBA experience, guys. Hello.
Vaibhav, if you want, you can talk. And Ashif. Oh, can you rejoin it? I think he is not able to hear.
Hello.
Vaibhav, we are able to hear you.
Hey, this is Ashif. Can you hear me now?
Yes, yes, Ashif. Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, hello, Vaibhav. Do you have any experience on this one? Any experience on solve management skills? Fine, guys, we'll go. So let's go for Solman. So Solman is one, it's just a, the standard tool, SAP tool for, we can install on top of this. So here, if we take any real-time scenario, so we maintain the OLTP scenario, like OLTP machine. Suppose this is my company. So my company always runs on the OLTP system. So I can use the different databases. I can use SQL, I can use Oracle, I can use HANA, I can use any systems. So when the end user enter the record, so this record will go to expert of the databases. Again, this is OLTP, online transaction process. So what company will do for analytical, for analyzing the business, they'll try to maintain the a separate data warehousing concept called OLAP system, like OLAP system. Okay, so here the records are constant. They're stored up permanently. We call it historical data. Again, for this also, I can use any backend like SQL Server, Oracle, or HANA. Like I can use this multiple databases. Okay, so I can like this, I can use multiple databases, right? So here, what happened? So usually developers will try to load data from here to here and they'll do some modeling activities on the stuff. So if you want to do some modification, or if you want to do some monitoring, which is on the backend database, monitoring, if you want to do in the software operation, like complete administration work, if you want to do it, if this OLTP running on SAP CC, so the basis team will try to do the maintenance, configuration, monitoring, everything will take care by this basis team of SAP EC system. Similarly, if it is Windows system, so if it is SAP Windows system, again we have a separate team for Windows administration. Those guys will do the installation, configuration of the stuff and maintain the system. If instead of these systems, so if you have, so I'm working for the different landscape. I'm working on different landscape where I have the different databases like connected Sybase, HANA, SQL, Oracle, like this one. Okay. So understanding or monitoring all the systems at one place is very difficult. So what we do is, so we use a standalone SAP system because SAP will maintain a standalone system on which we don't use any application. If you take SAP ECC, SAP ECC is an application. Backend, it may be a database. SAP BW is an application. And backend, we may use a database. Yes, solution manager, if you use this Solman, a standalone tool, I can connect the multiple databases. I can connect the Sybase, HANA, I can have the SQL Server, I can connect the Oracle, I can do the managed monitoring. So for all system at a time, I can log in the DBA cockpit, I can do monitoring, I can do the alerts checking, I can check the system info, I can check the hardware part. Okay. I can check the all the patches. I can check the newly software installed. So alerts, all complete basis information, the system healthy part, we can check it here. So these are different things taking place. Okay. This is how we'll maintain. So if you take any business scenarios here, so what the Solman will do, the Solman will try to monitoring all the stuff. So we need to log in the Solman and we have to use a certain T code and monitoring all the different databases, because on this different databases, the maybe a different application running in the front end. For Sybase, we may use a different application. For HANA, we may use a different application. For Oracle, we may use different applications running on this backend databases. So I can also monitoring the same individual at a time, as well as I can also monitoring all the machines at a time for the Solman. There's an advantage in the Solman. The Solman is a standalone tool. So what we do is we try to connect all the multiple databases and we do configuration. But now in the 7.2 latest version is Solman. Previously we use a SAP screen, SAP GUI screen, where I can log in, I can do all the activity. So as the new generation changes, so we got a kind of a dashboard, a Fiori web-based dashboard. We can log into the web portal page, our mobile devices, iPhone, iPad, supporter tools. So from anywhere, I can log in this Solman. I can connect the multiple systems where I get the a beautiful dashboard. So instead of logging the T code, I can monitor all at one place in the a proper icons, like the graphically, okay? Some game like this things. Okay, so we'll get like a kind of boxes. We'll get where we can monitor. We do. We can check the activities, and as well as we can also generate our report properly in a beautiful chart format. If I want to check the business cases, I can check the business health scenario, the errors, system checking, the dashboard, like the column chart, pie chart, other different types of chart. We can use, I can create a customized dashboard so I can analyze my business properly. Okay, so these are different dashboard you can generate. So reporting dashboard need to be generated based on our requirement. These are advantages here. Clear, guys? So this is what a solution manager. Solution manager is a standalone tool where I can connect the multiple databases. I can do monitoring or I can do all this activity in one place. So in solution manager, we can learn the how we can do monitoring, checking, alert checking, configuration, all the stuff, as well as a new beautiful reports. How I can generate the standalone reports for error checking, hardware health checkup, for all the different scenarios. We try to analyze the business and we check the solution manager activities. So I'll show you the new version of the solution manager, how it's look like, all the stuff. So I'll show you the course agenda of this solution manager, as like the number of days and how it's all stuff. So solution manager is one place where we can get all the information at one place. Okay. So we can do monitoring all the stuff. So nowadays in 7.2, we can create a beautiful dashboard as per requirement. The dashboard will be taking help of the Bex query actually. So here we're learning about the normal, the architecture of landscape, the new, the different types of templates, management solutions and Ubuntu, the different types of integration managers. If you take business process monitoring, how we can do the overview of the things, how we can set up, configure the monitoring tabs for each and every individual databases individually, troubleshooting of those systems, alerts checking, and the configuration of user experience monitoring, which is dashboard builder, how we can get a user defined, the user cases, the different types of features, integration, the dashboard builder configuration, the complete process we can check on this thing. So we can create a user defined dashboard here. So we also have the technical bill of materials here. The BPCA configuration, all those activities, and business process changes, analyzer part. And we also have solution manager, the new versions from 7.0 to 7.2 version right now. Understanding change impact of the tool, business case tool, and how we can do test the different types of test automated framework with the CBTA tool and the configuration, all those things. Okay, the test configuration, execution of CBTA, a user, we have a TDC and external data source, all those system configuration will take place. So that's what we are focusing on, these business cases. So how we can work out all the stuff. Okay. So the configuration monitoring of each and every databases we can connect, how we can check this health checkup of each and every system individually, monitoring part, if your job setting, how we can do a job scheduling process, creating a new dashboard builder, just like a report developer, okay, access the data process, new versions, all we're learning each and everything in the detail in the practical systems. It's clear, any queries on this one? So we'll focus on the four different scenarios we have. So we're focusing on the, I'm sure it takes around 45 hours. So we'll spend daily 1 hour session, all those time. Okay. So we'll provide this, the course content has a software agenda, the software for hands-on practice. Okay. And the new version 7.2 latest edition of books, the PDF files, and stuff.
That's a mommy.
No, okay. Okay. Yeah. It was just a tool, the social manager, the sign-on tool, where you can connect the multiple database and just move the monitor. But we need to understand how it will be useful, like how we can do configurations, the monitoring, security part, backup recovery activities, the other newly software updated, patches updated, for each and every activities, and transport activities, so for us.
Always.
Okay. So, any questions, guys, till now? Guys, if you have any questions, let me know.
Hey, Raju.
Yes, tell me.
This is Asif. I have one question.
Yes.
What are the basic change between the 7.0 and 7.1 and 7.2? Do you know? Can you describe?
Yeah. Which one?
What are the basic change between the 7.1 and 7.2?
Yes. 7.1 and 7.2, that we take 7.2, we got a new way of designing part, which is called dashboard, the SAP Fiori dashboard. Okay, like we call UFI dashboard, which is a web-based application tool. And we don't need to go with any T course. If you take in the Solomon, if you want to check the monitoring of the stuff, we have to go DBA cockpit, some T course, and as well as we do some configuration over there. In dashboard, it's a new beautiful dashboard. Every icon is just like an icon only, like a phone app, phone application. And the 7.2 version is supported for the iPhone, iPad, and Android devices application directly. So it means we can log in from phone and you can do monitoring the our device every day with a secure login. The advantage. And we got has we as a solution manager is a DBA administration part, but the we got the a ready-made tool like we can generate our own reports. So I can check for this machine how many failures, like if you take any jobs, so how many jobs are failure, how many jobs are success, and what are the system information, like what is the status of the hardware, CPU, RAM, the size of the files in every drive allocated, the file system allocated, those things. And we can check the all the health cases in the graphical manner, like pie chart, column chart, column. So we can design our own report as per requirement. This is the advantage. The creating a new report, the view, so, the design part.
Hey, Raju.
Yeah.
How are we pulling the data in solution manager from the other satellite system?
So yeah, data insertion we'll do with the help of that. We have, so if you take SAP HANA, so we'll do SLT concept is there. We have import export option.
From the other system, the managed system, how are we pulling the data from there to solution manager? What is the tool are we using?
Which one are you with you? Data forms?
The data from the satellite system or managed system, how are we pulling the data? How are we getting the data from there into the solution manager?
If it is SAP systems, so maximum all the different types of databases are connected to a solution manager. So we need to get a proper connection. We got some, if it is SAP, we need to get a RC connection, remote partition call connection. And if it is other system, we need to give some DB connection. So once the connection is established, we can read, we can try to read the entire data information of the particular database.
Now, how the solution manager getting the data information for system landscape into solution manager, how it's, what is the mechanism, what is the tool that solution manager is using?
The solution manager can act as a DBA cockpit, DBA format. So what it will do, it will touch the database, it touch the, it has when you're getting connection, the solution manager is just an application, like a, just an application tool, like a web portal page, like a web page kind of thing. So that will try to connect the database and will try to read the, all the system information internally, because the solution manager is that that because the logic is written in the system internally.
Hey Raju, how the system data gets pulled into solution manager from other how system data gets pulled into solution manager from the other system?
So it will do with the help of replication part.
Okay, what tool is using for replication?
We use the SLA tool, SAP Landscape Transformation tool.
What is that?
SAP Landscape Transformation.
No. No, that's not using
I'll
Hello?
Yeah, hello?
Okay, one more question.
Yes.
For example, I have a document on 7.1. I want to pull into 7.2. How can I do that?
Yeah, we do a migration. So we have we can just upgrade your system. 7.1 to 7.2, we have certain patches are we have this. You can just download those software, or you can just upload it. We can do upgradation. So we can do two things. We can use a DMO tool is there, data migration tool is there. We can with that we can upgrade our system, or we can do it upgradation directly.
Okay, cool. You say you're gonna teach us how to do a business process monitoring, right?
Yes.
So what is the going to be like hands-on training, like are we going to be watching what you're doing, or are you going to give us some project?
Yes, yeah. While teaching the same thing, so we have a software with me, online server. a login system. I'll show you the practicals and everything, as well as I'll use the same server to do hands-on for you, as well as I'll give you some the software soft copy for each and every topic.
Okay, all right. Okay, cool.
Okay, fine. So I'm going to share the course agenda as per days and stuff.
Hello.
Okay. Yeah.
Hello.
Yeah,
yeah, Rajiv, I have a few questions.
Yes.
Yeah, on which database this, and on which Solman version we will learning this Solman training?
On database, you said I have HANA is there, HANA and Oracle. HANA, SQL and Oracle, three machines are there. So mostly we learn on the HANA and SQL, these two.
Okay, HANA and SQL. And we will be including installation part also in our training, right?
Yes, of course.
Okay, and at what till charm you charm is also included till charm configuration?
Yes, of course, yeah.
Yeah, we will cover it, right?
Yes, yeah. That will see how we can do configuration part.
Yeah, and one more thing. And which systems we are going to add? Is there any Java system also we going to add, or only we will?
No. Only SAP Solman for backend, HANA and Oracle. We don't need any Java.
No, but while adding some system configuration, we will add system also, right?
Okay, yeah. You think that that while adding connection, okay, fine. Okay, yeah. Of course, we use. But here, the system which we have, the online server which we are taking, it's already pre-configured for the solution manager and backend HANA and SQL. Anyways, we'll try to close that connection.
But you will teach us from scratch, right?
Yes. We'll just close.
Yeah, it's possible, right? Because my training is dependent on that I have to learn most of the basis part. Installation, okay. Configuration, till charm that rather than dashboard.
Okay. Yes.
Is solution manager is a dual stack or single stack? Is solution manager is a dual stack or single stack?
Not anything.
Solution manager is a dual stack or single stack?
Single stack.
I'm sorry, single?
Yes.
Oh. So we don't need the Java stack for solution manager? No?
Java stack we need for the to connect SQL. Our other database like SQL, Oracle, for Sybase HANA we don't need.
Okay, cool.
That will be no sure. Fine.
Cool.
Okay. Fine. Yeah. So I'll gonna share a course agenda. Have a concept and we'll start section.
Raju, please share the course in detail, right?
Of course, yeah, in detail, yes. Yeah. I just showed you during this audio the course agenda, but I'll share the course in detail.
Vaibhav, we will share. Don't worry about that. Okay.
Okay. No problem.
Thank you. Any guys? Okay, guys. So we'll start the session from tomorrow. Okay. Bye then.
Okay. I hope we people clarify the doubts. Okay. So we're going to share the course agenda and all the details. Okay, how much duration, P, and all the when it is going to start and what is the time, convenient time. We'll share the details. Okay.
All right. Cool.
Right. If you have any questions, please you can raise now regarding this demo.